On this episode of Make or Break, we are back at the amazing Volkswagen Training Centre here in Milton Keynes, and I'm here with the legend Jack from SolidPrint. How's it going, mate?
Yeah, good, thanks, Freddie.
So, on the last episode, we were trying to work out if our doors were actually from this car and if they were real. And by the gentleman that worked in Volkswagen, he assumed by his technical background that they were real. But you have something a little bit special to actually officially tell us if they're real or not.
We certainly do. So we've got some scanning equipment and we'll take a look down to about 20 microns accuracy as to whether they're actually the real deal.
Amazing. And you've got over 60,000 pounds of equipment to do that for us.
Exactly that. So the free track, we'll scan the car and we'll take a look at every single panel and see what's real.
I don't know about you lovely people at home, but I am freaking jumping off my seat. Let's do it. So this is a 2004 Volkswagen Touran. In 2004, that was over 20 years ago, this car was developed and used for the Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift. And I'll tell you what, it is pretty mundane in European standards, but in America, this car does not grace the roads. It is available in Japan, it's available in Tokyo, where the design of the movie was placed, but this car would have never been filmed in America. There are eight panels on this car, which are most important to us today. Number one, the bonnet, which we don't need any of that. That is a standard panel that we can put a wrap on. Both of these front fenders, which is our, in England, is our wings. So you've got a right hand and a front hand wing. Then you've got your both of your front doors, a right and a left hand. And then we're on to our rear doors. So you've got another pair of rear doors and they are all individual, okay? The most important thing you need to know is none of these fists on this car have been replicated onto another panel, which we found out earlier on in one of my other videos. But then last but not least, is that boot lid. That boot lid with that whacking great foot hanging out the back of it is our fundamental part that we have to get correct. In working with SolidPrint, we know that we can accurately scan this car in its formality. Every single form, every single angle, every single detail is going to be copied. And that will allow us to work out if the parts I've got back home, which I purchased on Facebook, are original, are they real, do they match up? But using SolidPrint and the amazing guys at Volkswagen Technical College here in Milton Keynes, they're allowing us to 3D scan it. I think this is possible. Check out the scanning process. This will absolutely blow your mind. My hair is out of control, but I can assure you the design and the 3D scan of this car will be completely on point. What everyone else has struggled with is they've only had a film to go by, so they can guess how the fists look, whereabouts they were, they can grab screen prints, but what they can't get is the details that a 3D scan can get. With the £60,000 machine we're using today, he's gonna show me that each and every single molding, every single imprint, every single crevice in this fist. George, what the hell are you doing, man? The last time I saw anyone with anything like this was Magneto in X-Men. It looks pretty special. It looks like a massive Easter egg in your hand. What's going on?
Yeah, so basically we've got essentially a laser scanner here that we're scanning the car with. Around it is various targets, which this tracker behind you there is looking at this and knows where I am in space and time. So this allows us to scan completely targetless. And essentially I can go around getting a high quality scan, you know, down to 20 microns here to get us the data we need to do that comparison. If I want to get in there, I just need a point and shoot. It's going to track me where I am in space. You can see on the laptop there, we're now looking into that zone. As long as you're the right distance, you'll get everything you need to get. And then even the little bits of dust that we've got on the car today from it being outside.
My main question really is, obviously, I don't know how this works, but I would be concerned in my head that you're going to go over it once, you can go over here, you can come back, you can go over it as many times as you want, and it'll always pick up more and more detail, correct?
Yeah, pretty much. It'll come a point where we'll hit sort of the maximum for that surface, but you can see on the screen there, we've got different differentials of colours where we can essentially see where we need to go back over. So if I'm missing some data, I can go over here. But if I just want to get kind of the main bits, you know, are going to be the bits that we're looking for the molding here. But then when we're going back around the car, there's certain panels I don't need to worry about. So as long as I catch that and link the scan together, that'll help me later down the line, potentially merge more scans together.
Right.
But for now, yeah.
This will pick them up completely as one item so that when we scan my doors at your location, we should be able to imprint the 3D scan of this car over the top of the other one and see if they're an exact match.
Yeah, exactly. So basically we'll pick off reference points that we can use any geometry on that panel from the deviation down here to the actual fist itself.
From a layman's point of view, This could basically help you replicate any part in the world. So if this part is obsolete, this mirror or this door itself, you could replicate that in a 3D form so that it could be replicated in a mold, a steel mold, fiberglass, carbon fiber, and then you have not lost that part of the car ever again.
Yeah, we've had various different cases where we've scanned parts that are redundant, new parts that are broken, and we've been able to scan it in and even repair off some of those broken parts to replicate it. But if you've got a scan of the original thing, then you can, in theory, replicate it to be pretty much precisely to the original.
So, Jack, you saw my video all about the amazing car. And you know what? My passion's behind it. Like, you could really see that this is loads of fun for me and my heart's in it. Why me, man? Why did you reach out to offer me this amazing help from SolidPrint?
Sure. So, look, I guess SolidPrint, you know, we've got a wide choice of different products. And I knew that we had the right products maybe to try and help with this. I could see your passion and I wanted to make sure we got the right job done. So I brought along the shining products and hopefully we can get it done bang on.
That is it. I mean, they are shining products. You've brought over 60,000 pounds of equipment today just to scan this car. Not only is it fast, it's precise, but your heart's behind it as well. You know that when you get back, that data stored on that computer is going to be right first time. You won't have to second guess it.
No, exactly that. We can get it bang on straight away. Hopefully get that data back to you and look forward to see what's happening.
That's amazing. I mean, I had quite a few people that were reaching out to me from different companies all around the country saying, we can offer 3D printing, we can do this, we can do that. And it's just sort of like, oh, please email us at this and please do this. What you did was you personally reached out to me as a human being and was like, I work for an amazing company, I'm proud of it. Would you consider teaming up with us for this project? And that personal aspect of the way you contacted me was so important. I phoned you, you picked up the phone, I could speak to a human. And is that the same with any customer that works with you guys?
Exactly that. I always like to offer the same support. The whole team are exactly the same, so you can reach out to them at any point and they're always happy to help.
It's amazing. I spoke to your colleague earlier and George was mentioning that like the idea of this equipment is that you can replicate items that are no longer available.
Sure, so we cover a lot of different aspects, automotive, medical, aerospace. There's lots of different aspects, but this sort of equipment is not only for reverse engineering, but also inspection. So the likes of manufacturers can confirm and ensure that all these parts are bang on from their suppliers.
So what I'm getting from that is like when you develop the product, so let's say you're making this bonnet for Volkswagen and you have a mold that prints over 50,000 of these in 2 weeks' time, yeah? Over those 2 weeks, there'd be certain parts of the mold itself that can break away, can change. And basically by doing a 3D scan to make sure you're in tolerance, that means that none of these items have changed. None of this line here, the swage marks, the where the panel ends, all those items can be checked with what you're doing. Is that correct?
Correct, exactly that. So we can check and set everything up to a tolerance. We can generate a report and outcomes that report will tell you each individual product is within tolerance.
Is scanning just what SolidPrint does or is there other aspects to your company as well?
No, certainly. So there's a wider aspect as well. So we also cover 3D printing, desktop manufacturing. So including PCB manufacturing printers, desktop water jet cutters. There's certainly a wide range. We like to help and cover every aspect because printing's not always the right choice.
And without the guys at SolidPrint, this would not be achievable to a grade which is 99.99999% right. In some ways, it's going to be 100% accurate. And, you know, we're talking, what's the tolerance level you said?
So we're talking 20 microns accuracy. So that's 0.02 of a millimeter.
That is absolutely ridiculous. There's no one in the world with a human set of eyes that could tell the difference. A massive thanks to SolidPrint. This is absolutely amazing. I'm so proud to be working with SolidPrint. And if anyone at home has the same idea, you need to follow the link in the bio below. But make sure that you're also following and subscribing and put comments below on how they think we should develop the car further. And if we could actually make these, what way would we do it?